Welcome back to Lyric Hi-Fi on another January afternoon. Like in the previous video, I have put on my Outcast t-shirt. This is in order for you to age me and judge me from my taste in music and also how old I am, because these guys were playing around Belfast when I was at school. And in fact, I've now ruined their street cred completely because most of them played tennis at the local tennis club. So just get how punk that is. But do check out the Outcasts, they're still around, and maybe if you actually check them out on Spotify, they'll even get paid 5p or something like that. So anyway, do that. For all the geeks among you, there's more than the Outcasts to talk about, because I'm going to talk about system supports, the stands that you put your hi-fi equipment on. Because over the years, these have become more and more expensive with more and more options. And one of the companies I've dealt with for a long time, who are at the forefront of this, is a company called Quadraspire. Quadraspire are based in the south of England, somewhere near Bath in some leafy suburb, and they export all over the world, and they make stands largely out of wood, although some of them now out of bamboo to be very light and stiff, and they've got a great reputation. So when you look at some of their stands like this, they're priced per shelf, and you can have the shelf in a cherry or a black or a white. Obviously they do rosewood finishes and all different types of finish, and as you go up in the range, it just gets more expensive. Now, why do you need all these? Well, these have got nice little spikes into the ground. You can have floor protectors if you want to protect your nice wooden floor or tile floor. And that allows you to set this up and make it really fixed and rigid so that nothing vibrates. Some people talk about making stands very, very heavy and using marble, but Quadraspire don't really believe that's a good idea. If you make it out of something heavy like marble, you don't make it more rigid. All you do is make it vibrate at a lower frequency. And that lower frequency that it vibrates at could be much worse for your hi-fi system than making it better. So we're really talking about working the other way and making the shelves as light and stiff and rigid as possible. If you're using a turntable on it, those higher frequencies don't cause problems where the lower frequencies will. Now, everyone can understand that vibrations can affect the sound of a turntable, but it seems a bit more geeky and mad to think that it changes the sound of electronics. But electronics can be affected by this as well, and the same thing applies. Big, large amplitude vibrations at low frequencies are probably worse than high frequencies. I have to say, although we talk about some of this, I try not to be too geeky about this, because my end product is, if you set your system on this instead of that and it sounds better and you can afford it, then why not buy it? And it's as simple as that. So the first level of Quadraspire system, each shelf is about £150. So a shelf of four tiers would be £600. Dead easy. This, of course, is a more expensive one. This is called SVT. The shelves are all cut into slots so that they're lighter and even stiffer. They're different material, and they're much thicker uprights. And so per shelf in this, you're at £300. So there you are, at something that's £1,200. A few years ago, about 18 months ago now, Quadraspire finished working on something that was to be their reference, or as they call it, their X-reference. And that was something where they just, what can we do as an ultimate level of this? So this is the X-reference. Each shelf is made of bamboo, which is incredibly light and stiff. And each shelf then has brass supports onto brass spikes into a support on the shelf or the support beneath. And each one is all done like this. And so this is a very expensive way of doing it. In fact, whenever I tell you the price of this, I just start to smile, because it's £1,100 per shelf. So that's basically £3,000 worth. And you think, £3,000 for a rack? Well, yes, it's a load of money, but if your system's £5,000 or £10,000 and this is going to make a big improvement, then maybe it's worth it. So what we're going to do now is a demonstration. And a demonstration over a recording, over YouTube, over your phone or your laptop, or maybe over headphones. Will you actually hear any difference? I have no idea. Maybe you will and maybe you won't. we'll hear the difference in here. So we're going to play, I don't know, a couple of minutes of music on this. Then we'll cut and move this entire system to the next shelf and let you hear that as well. Now, in terms of what we've got here, it's quite interesting to know what level of equipment we're using, because obviously if the whole system's £1,000, spending all that money on a support for it doesn't make any sense. This is the Riga Planner 8 turntable, which is one down from their top range, and it's featuring a moving coil cartridge called an Afita. So that turntable is £2,300 for that, along with its own dedicated power supply. The signal comes off the record and then into this, which is a moving coil phono stage, which is £895. It's called a Riga Aria Mark III. And that comes out of that and into the Riga Ethos, which is their newest amplifier, which has just had incredible reviews from all the magazines when it was launched over the past year. And it's, well, if you give me £3,000, I'll give you a fiver back. So it's a pretty expensive amplifier. And that is then fed into the KEF R11 speakers, which are a gorgeous thing, beautiful shape, using KEF's technology of the treble unit mounted in the middle of the mid-range unit, and then four bass units in what's called a Dapolito configuration. So when you add all that up, frankly, you're around about £10,000 for the rest for this system. So if you've got £10,000, what's the difference between spending £1,000 on a rack and £3,000? You might as well have the better one anyway. But let's do the demonstration and see if you can hear the difference. So we'll start and let you hear some of this. So there we are. Did you hear a difference? What do you think of the music? Well, standing here, we all heard a difference. The horns, saxophones were cleaner and clearer and more dynamic. The guitar sounded much better. So if you fancy one of these, you should maybe come in and have a listen for yourself. Or if you want, just order one. We're fine. We're locked down. You can't hear it at the moment anyway. But someday we'll be back to normal. We'll be doing demonstrations and you'll be welcome to come in have a look around and see all this kind of different gear we have here. For now, we are going to do more videos, so please subscribe and then we'll let you know whenever they're coming out. And if there's anything you fancy buying, Brenton will put up on the bottom now, michael@lyrichifi.com is how you get hold of me, and just fire me an email and we're happy to help. Thanks for watching. See you soon.